What is allergic rhinitis and what are its symptoms?
Allergic rhinitis is when our body's immune system is mounting an immune response against the things that we are coming in contact with. In allergic rhinitis, it's usually things that we're breathing in, either pollen in the air, ragweed, tree pollen, grass pollen, those things. But also the perennial or all year round allergens like dust mites and molds and pet dander, all those things. So we breathe those in, they enter into our nasal membranes. Our body thinks they're something bad, like a virus or a bacteria, and it mounts an immune response. And so that immune response then creates swelling, inflammation, itching, sneezing, itchy watery eyes, which is allergic conjunctivitis, but they often go together. Congestion, nasal discharge. It's usually more of a clear, thin, watery discharge, but it can be thicker, especially if there's any infectious things going on as well.
What's the difference between seasonal and perennial allergic rhinitis?
Seasonal allergic rhinitis is typically related to pollens. And so the pollens, the trees bloom and have pollen in the spring. Grass is really hit more in the summer. Weeds hit more in the fall. And then through the winter, we don't really have a lot of pollen in the air. The seasonal allergic rhinitis is when someone's allergic to just one of those things and they have that. Spring and fall are our classic times where we see people that have the worst problems from often tree pollen in the spring and weeds in the fall. Perennial allergies are when you're allergic to the things that are never going away, like dust mites or pet dander if you have pets in your home, molds, which you're constantly exposed to.
Do patients need to visit an allergist before seeking treatment from you?
In general, I manage those allergic disorders myself. We have, in my office, we do allergy testing, we do immunotherapy, so allergy shots, we do some sublingual immunotherapy, which is allergy drops that people can use, and then just the whole host of medical things. I think that's one of the things I like especially well about our practice is we really try to manage it from both ends. So we try to be able to provide more of a comprehensive management for nasal disorders. I think when you are too focused on any one problem, you'll treat that with the things that you have available. And I like to have all those treatment options available to really give the patient the best outcomes.
How can you tell the difference between an allergy and a cold?
Yeah, that can be challenging sometimes. Often it's the duration of the symptoms. So, you know, a cold should be gone within 10 days of onset. Allergies are often going to be cyclic, like we talked about, or if they're perennial, then you're going to be something that persists. Sometimes it's challenging to tell that chronic sinusitis scenario that from allergies. And many times people have not one, but they have both. And so allergy testing is very helpful. Having CT scans and other things to look for the chronic sinusitis is often necessary. You know, a rough rule that's not perfect, but one that we sometimes follow is if it's more clear, thin, watery discharge, it's more likely to be allergic, whereas if it's thicker, discolored nasal discharge, it's probably more likely to be an infectious or chronic inflammatory disorder.
What are the treatments for allergic rhinitis?
There are a lot of treatments for allergic rhinitis, simple as just avoiding the things that you're allergic to. And so one advantage in allergy testing is being able to educate people on the things they need to try to avoid. Antihistamines like Claritin, Benadryl, Zyrtec, over-the-counter, and there's some prescription versions that are very good. Nasal steroid sprays are also very helpful. Flonase and Nasacort, Nasonex, those are excellent. There are a lot of other adjuvant therapies. There's a medicine called Montelukast that's both used for asthma and allergies. It's helpful. There are allergy eye drops that can be used. There's different allergic topical sprays that can be used in the nose.
What is immunotherapy?
Immunotherapy is something that's also very helpful. That's where once someone has been allergy tested and we know what they're allergic to, we can give them either allergy shots or sublingual drops that will help their body's immune system try to ignore those things. So now they're really treating the cause of the problem, which is that overactive immune system.
When is it time to seek treatment from an otolaryngologist?
I think if you're having, you know, congestion and drainage for a couple of weeks in the spring and a couple of weeks in the fall, and they're managed adequately with an antihistamine, then, you know, that's fine to take care of it on your own. if you're having symptoms that are all year round and they're really starting to hamper your lifestyle, then I think that's when really medical management by a physician is necessary.
For more information or to schedule an appointment with Dr. Heberlin, please call 304-399-2271.